open the November 4th meeting of the North Hampton License Commission. All the commissioners are present. We are audio and video recording this meeting, as always. Is there any public comment at this time on any matter not on the agenda or some other pressing business? Hearing none, I will move to the first item on the agenda, application for short-term wine and malt license, Available Potential Enterprises Limited, APE. Are they not here? We will move then to the next item, application for change of manager, Freedom Post 28, DBA American Legion. Proposed new manager, Jane?
Duffus, yes.
And you are Jane?
I am.
And welcome.
She has her new court form in there, in line with that, what we just did.
Okay.
Okay.
So you've got the court form, and we have everything checked. And have you been working at the Legion for a while?
For about 8 years.
Have you managed anywhere else prior to this, to the manager?
No. Okay.
And you are TIPS or Serve Safe trained?
I am.
Okay. And there's no other changes going on in the Legion Hall. Do you have any questions for Ms. Duffus?
No.
Okay. I'll make a motion then that we approve the change of manager from William Mazuk to Jane Duffus immediately. Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Oh, and the 443. I need, let me append to that motion that authorized me to. Issue the 443 back to the ABCC. No problem there. I will sign this. Okay. Thank you, Ms.
Thank you.
APE. Go back to you. So you have an application for a short-term wine and malt license for Friday, December 18th, at Rabbit's Reception. Just tell us what the event will be like.
It will be in an APE gallery space on 126 Main Street. The exhibition is an alumni exhibition of APE artists, so participating artists, as well as the public is invited. So it'll be a 3-hour reception from 5 to 8 p.m. We'll be serving some snacks and some wine and seltzer. And that's it.
Okay. And I see that we have the information about your servers, your distributor, and you are a not-for-profit yourselves. So this is just a short-term wine and malt license for that date as specified. Do we have the fee?
I brought a check.
Great. Okay. Any questions? You're Lisa Thompson.
Yes, yeah.
Sorry, any questions for Ms. Thompson?
None.
No.
I'll hear a motion for this.
I'll make a motion to approve the requested license.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
I think I can give you
item number 7, application for short-term all alcohol license, St. Elizabeth Ann Seton, Polish Heritage Committee. Is this the same as this old St. John Canchus event?
It is.
Okay.
It's,
let's see, the tradition continues.
Yes. Each year we try to have lots of fundraisers to help defray the cost of our annual Pulaski Drinking Parade, so we have one in the springtime and one here in the fall.
Okay. And this is coming up this weekend?
Yes, Sunday.
And
from noon to 6.
All right. And we will we'll get the insurance info to Cindy after we take action here today. And I see that we have information on the servers, TIPS train, your certificate of exemption, and the distributor is listed on here. The profits will go to the Polish Heritage Committee.
Right.
Do you have any questions for Mr. Bjorkes? So, motion. You want to make a motion?
Please.
Make a motion to go ahead and grant the short-term, is it short-term? Yeah, short-term all alcohol license for St. Elizabeth and CD, Polish Heritage Committee. Okay, second, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Double the fees. Oh, because it's all alcohol, of course, I'm sorry. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Good luck with the event.
Thank you.
Okay, item number 8, renewal request for King Street Eats. Kelly?
I will be in my office tomorrow, 8:30 to 4:30.
Okay.
I don't see Kelly here.
Put it to the end.
Item number 9, application for short-term wine and malt license for Forbes Library.
Yes, so we're having an artist.
Wait, hold on a second.
I'm so sorry.
Hold on, that's okay. That's okay.
I'm not a trustee yet.
Okay.
So I don't have to accuse myself. Don't get sworn in until January.
Congratulations.
I'm staring at her.
Very excited.
All right, so tell us what this event is about.
So this is in our Hosmer Gallery up on the second floor of the library, and it's our monthly artist reception. It's a print and photograph show, and the reception will run from 2:30 to 4:30, and we have an application in for one day, the short-term wine and malt license.
Okay. I see that we have the information here.
But no red wine.
Servers.
No red wine. Yeah, because of the oriental carpet that's there, we just do white wine.
Really?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You put down plastic like they do in like baseball locker rooms.
Right. It might take away from the environment, but yes, we could do that.
The spray and champagne. All right. I see that we have everything here for your application to proceed, and you are requesting a fee waiver. Are there any questions for the panel?
No.
Nope.
I will make a motion then to approve this short-term wine and malt license for Forbes Library for November 21st with a fee waiver.
I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. Here's
your thing.
Oh gosh, here's where I came in at last time. Request for approval population for City of Northampton for renewal process.
Mm-hmm.
I never can figure out why we get stuck with this.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we get stuck with this?
We are the local licensing authority, and we are sort of the intermediary between the ABCC, which sets the quota, and
this
city.
Okay.
So
we're certifying for ABCC.
Okay, yeah, they get the census numbers come into the state. All this stuff comes into ANF. ANF eventually gives it to the treasurer's office, the ABCC. And then we just have to say, yeah, they didn't make a typo or something like that. We just have to be the backstop on this.
I mean, this is for the population. Our amount of license is wrong.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, it hasn't changed in years because it's from the federal census, and the federal census is only done every 10 years, so.
We do this every year. What's our population?
I do the same as it was last 8 years.
28,549. So, and that hasn't changed because we won't have another one. Unless sometimes the feds will do some sort of interim thing, but it probably never happens. So
make a motion that we approve 28,549 as the correct number for census purposes.
Second.
All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay, you all have to sign this.
Sign our life away.
You're working on a record, my friend.
What? Oh, yeah, I know. Ooh, 15 minutes. Okay, approval minutes from July 30th meeting and minutes from September 2nd meeting. We also have the minutes from the October 7th meeting. So, let me hear a motion first for the July 30th meeting. Approve all the minutes.
I'll make a motion to approve July 30th.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay, I wasn't at the September 2nd meeting.
And you can just put down, Cindy, that I abstained from voting since I wasn't present.
Okay, I will do the same thing for this one, September 2nd. Do I hear a motion to approve these minutes?
Same motion.
And I will second it.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Okay. October 7th.
Wait, just 1 second. I'm sorry. Just because we want to set a record.
Okay. October 7th, Brian, you weren't here. I'll make a motion, unless there's some change, to approve the October 7th.
And I will second that.
All those in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. Let me just note, I did meet with the chief afterwards, just so, because I used to meet with Russ from time to time, informally, and had a great conversation. We talked about the compliance checks, and she's, I said we were happy with the way they were doing them, and spoke for us, I hope you don't mind. And she was happy with the way that we disposed of them. Okay.
All right, good.
She thought.
I'd like to be on the same page.
Yeah. And so it was a useful meeting. And last item, discussion of proposed rules and regulations for.
No, we did that last meeting.
We did, okay. Sorry.
That's very.
I see the sorry now. Okay. Very sorry. All right.
So do we forward Tully's to next?
Well, can I just bring it up? Yeah. I have a question.
Okay.
He is trying to decide if he wants to renew the license to be able to sell it. It's an annual wine and malt. But it's not being used at the time, and he doesn't have a premise in mind yet. So I didn't know if
how
I should put
it in
the renewal process.
Aren't
this one of the pre-existing annual wine and malt licenses?
Aren't those unlimited in the city though?
Why unless it's one of the ones that came before the special act where it'll convert all the seasonals.
But depending on how much he wants to sell it for, somebody would have to pay the $1,550 and then a $5,000 conversion fee, where if they bought this, I'm wondering, I don't know what his plan is to sell it for.
Is there anybody waiting for one now?
No, yes, but they already have a seasonal.
When does it expire? It expires
in
November.
Meeting. Well, well, because it has to be renewed
November.
Before December.
Right, December 1st.
Well, since he has to pay with a renewal, right? How much? $1,500?
Yeah.
Otherwise, it sits dormant.
Go on.
Yeah. I would, in my opinion, would be to let it slide through and renew.
Okay. And how long has he had? How long has the place been defunct?
8 months. I don't know.
I don't know. I wasn't notified when it was.
It was King's Green. It was
right.
Like spring,
June,
wasn't it?
June or something?
Yeah.
I was going to say early summer. Because I remember going by and everybody was like, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
There was no notice or anything like that.
I also know it's kind of out of break here.
Yeah.
Fine. It hasn't been that long.
Maybe one thing if there were 10 people waiting, but then about himself.
Will you make a motion then?
I'll make a motion to go ahead and grant the request for the King Street Eats license. Well,
license
the wine and malt annual license.
Renewal.
To renewal.
Okay. Right.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Is that good?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. And then I see no further business. I'll move adjourned.
Second. I'll second that.
All those in favor?
Aye.
15 minutes.
Whoa.